Hello, my dear students. A very warm welcome to you. Now, earlier we have learned about present tense and past tense. Today, we'll begin with future tense. Future tense also has four forms, that is simple future, future continuous, future perfect and future perfect continuous. So let's begin with simple future tense. Simple future tense is used to say or predict that something will happen very soon or later. It is formed by adding shall or will to the root verb. Now let us see the forms of simple future tense in statements, interrogative sentences and negative sentences. So the form of simple future in statement is subject plus shall or will plus present, that is first form of verb. For example, I shall go to Agra tomorrow. Second example, you will help him in his difficulty. Now, I is the subject. Subject plus shall or will. Shall plus present, that is first form of verb, that is go. And remaining part of sentence. You subject plus shall or will. So you will help is the verb in the first form. Him in his difficulty is the remaining part of the sentence. So that is the form of statements in simple future tense. Now let us see the form in interrogative sentences. So the form is shall or will plus subject plus present, that is first form of verb, plus remaining part of sentence. For example, shall, subject I, go is the verb in first form, to Agra tomorrow. Shall I go to Agra tomorrow? Second example, will, you subject, help verb in first form, him in his difficulty, remaining part of the sentence. So will you help him in his difficulty? That is the interrogative form. Next, the form in negative sentences. Subject plus shall or will plus not plus present form of verb plus remaining part of sentence. So for example, I shall not go, not negative, isn't it? I shall not go to Agra tomorrow. You will not help him in his difficulty. So I is subject, shall, future, it indicates future, not go, negative form, to Agra tomorrow, remaining part of the sentence. You subject, will indicates future tense, not negative, help, first form of verb, him in his difficulty, remaining part of the sentence. So this is the form of negative sentences in simple future tense. Now, let us see the uses of simple future tense. Simple future tense is used to say what we think will happen or to invite prediction. Means whatever we think that it will happen or if we predict something. So to tell that, we use simple future tense. For example, he will not help you at all.
example, the fair will last for a week. I shall not take the test tomorrow. So here, whatever we think that will happen in future, or whatever we predict about the future, or to express that, we use simple future tense. Second use is to indicate an offer or promise. If you want to offer something, or if you make a promise, for that we use simple future tense. For example, I will give you a nice gift if you pass. So that is an offer, or you can say that promise. If you pass, I will give you a nice gift. Next example, I shall buy the same shirt piece for you. So to make an offer or promise, we use simple future tense. Third use is to indicate an instant decision. Suppose at the time of speaking, you take some instant decision, quick decision. So to indicate that, we use simple future tense. For example, it is my birthday today. We will have a grand party. So this is the instant decision taken at the time of speaking. So to indicate that, we use simple future tense. Second example, it is raining very heavily. I will arrange an umbrella for you. So these are the instant decisions taken at the time of speaking. So to indicate that, we use simple future tense. Fourth use, to express hopes, expectations, etc. So if you want to express hopes or expectations, what we expect or what we hope, for that also we use simple future tense. For example, I expect India will win this test series. Second example, I hope she will get a job soon. So these are our expectations or hope. So to express that, we use simple future tense. Let's start with second form, that is future continuous tense. Future continuous tense indicates that something will occur in future and continue for expected length of time. So something will happen in future and it will continue. It will be in progress for an expected period of time. For that, we use future continuous tense. Let us see the form of future continuous tense in statements. So the form is subject plus shall or will be plus present participle, that is ing form of verb, plus remaining part of sentence. For example, the farmers, that is subject, will be plowing. Shall or will be plus ing form of verb. So will be plowing their fields early this year. Second example, I shall be writing to him next month. Shall be writing, it indicates future continuous tense. So let us see the form of future continuous tense in interrogative sentence. So the form is shall or will plus subject plus be plus present participle, that is ing form of verb, plus remaining part of the sentence. So same sentences we will turn into interrogative sentence. So first, shall or will. So will subject the farmers, will the farmers be ing form plowing their fields early this year. This is the remaining part of sentence. So will be plowing, it indicates future continuous tense. Second example, shall I be writing to him next month? Shall be writing. It indicates future continuous tense. Now let us see the form in negative sentences. Subject plus shall, will, not, plus be, plus present participle, plus remaining part of the sentence. Only what you have to do, you have to add not after shall or will. Other form is same in statements, isn't it? Let us see the same examples in negative. The farmers, that is your subject, will not be plowing their fields early this year. I, that is subject, shall not be writing work in future to him next month. So I shall not be writing to him next month. So this is the form of future continuous tense. Now let's see the uses of future continuous tense. Future continuous tense is used to describe action in progress in future. So the action which will continue in future, which will be in progress in future, for that we use future continuous tense. For example, tomorrow at this time I shall be taking my test. Shall be taking. So tomorrow at this time, which action will be going on? Which action will be in progress? Which action will be continuing? I shall be taking my test. So this action will be going on in future. Next, what will you be doing this evening? Will be doing. So in evening, now evening has yet to come. So in evening, what will you be doing? So some activity will be going on in future. So we use future continuous tense. Second use is to describe an event expected in normal course. So the event which is expected normally, to describe that event we use future continuous tense. For example, I shall be meeting her tomorrow morning. So this is an action which is going to happen in a normal course. So to describe that we use future continuous tense. Second example, the train will be leaving soon. Will be leaving. Okay, so to describe an event expected in normal course, we use future continuous tense. The third use is arrangements and plans. If we have made some arrangements or plans to do in future, for that we use future continuous tense. For example, we will be reaching Australia on Saturday. So this is the future plan which will be going on. So we will be reaching Australia on Saturday. Second example, they will be spending the summer vacation in Manali this year. So that action will be going on in future, which is a plan or arrangements. So if you have made any arrangements or any plans for the future, we use future continuous tense. Next is polite questions. So if you want to ask polite questions, we use future continuous tense. Instead of using only will, that is simple future, if you want to be more polite, we use future continuous tense. For example, when will you be finishing this work? So if a boss wants to ask the question to his employee in a polite way, so he can use future continuous tense, like when will you be finishing this work? Right? Second example, when will you be seeing Mr. Bajaj? Or suppose a secretary or assistant wants to ask the boss, so you can say, when will you be seeing Mr. Bajaj? Okay. So for polite questions, we use future continuous tense. Next use is to indicate an action which is a result of a routine. So the action which is a result of routine, our daily routine. So because of our daily routine, some actions takes place. For that we use future continuous tense. For example, she will be passing his house tomorrow. It is on her way home from work. Why will she be passing her house? Because her house is on her way home from work. So to go to work by that route is her routine. And because of that routine, because of it, the action of passing through her home takes place. So to describe that, we use future continuous tense. Second example, I shall be seeing Mr. Sharma tomorrow. We work in the same office. Now work in the same office, that is the routine. And because of this routine, what will be the result? I shall be seeing Mr. Sharma. Okay. So to describe the action which is a result of a routine, we use future continuous tense. I hope you have understood simple future and future continuous tense. In our next video, we will see future perfect and future perfect continuous tense. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.